Hello, welcome to this video guide. Let's see all the features you need to design 3D projects with ArchiCAD 20. Help us improve our future videos by leaving comments below. To design 3D architectural projects such as houses or buildings, ArchiCAD is one of the best software products, offering you several different templates, all listed inside the design section of the toolbox. To download a simple free house template, check out the link in the video description below. In this video, we will see the very basic features used to create 3D projects all inside the design section, but consider that you may need more practice and experience to make more complex designs. The wall tool is used to drop walls on your project. Fix two points on your workspace and the wall will appear as a 2D rectangle. This happens if you use the default 2D point of view called ground floor, as you can see on the tabs above. This is the standard preview also used to draw 2D projects and floor plans. If you switch to other views above, you can see that the object dropped is a 3D object, showing extrusion and a defined height. Basically, you have three main 3D previews: the elevations, the stories, and the free 3D points of view. The elevations are used to check your 3D project from several directions, starting from the ground. By default, you have four of them, indicating north, east, south, and west directions. You can check each of them by right-clicking and going to Open Elevation in the new tab. You can also create new custom elevations. Select an existing elevation and use Ctrl and C to copy, and then Ctrl and V to paste. Then click and drag to create a new elevation. After that, move, stretch, or rotate it as you do with 2D objects. The structure of the blue elevation object describes the characteristics of the related elevation view. The blue arrow represents the direction to preview your project. The segment length, the extension of the elevation preview. In fact, the objects that are not within this segment won't be shown in the preview. You also have the stories. The most important one is the ground floor view, used to check your project from up to down and used to design in 2D. When you open any elevation view, you can check all the existing stories, each laying at different height levels, just like the different floors of a building. Differently from the elevations, the stories are very useful to draw objects that must lay on a fixed height level. For example, if you draw a wall on the ground floor story, this will lay on the ground. But if you draw it on story 1, the object will lay on that height level above the ground itself. To edit stories, just right-click on one and go to Edit Story Levels. Then, click and drag to move the story, checking the story level value in the dialog box. You can also move multiple stories if you need. When you click on OK, the height level will be updated, and so will all the objects that lay on such story. All the different views are listed inside the Navigator palette that you can open by clicking on the small icon in the top right corner. You can check both the story and the elevation views. Just double-click on one to open it. You can also rename or create new views by right-clicking on one. Right-click on a story and go to Story Settings to check and adjust all the stories and their respective height. Besides elevations and stories, you can also check your project in a full and custom 3D preview. By default, you have a 3D tab above which shows a 3D preview. If you don't see it, you can open one by double-clicking on General Perspective or General Axonometry inside the Navigator palette. More below, you have all the visualization tools used to personalize your point of view. Use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out. Use the Orbit tool to rotate in 3D. Use the Escape key to finish with this tool. For a more direct experience, you can enable the Explore mode. This allows you to check your project completely as described in the dialog box. Use the Escape key to exit. Let's now see all the main tools used to build a 3D project. The tools inside the Design section are used to draw the main important structures of a building, such as walls, doors, or roofs, by using ready-made templates available in ArchiCAD. For example, if you enable the Wall or the Column tool, you will drop a wall or a column on your workspace by using a template that you can choose from the down arrow inside the main section of the info box, and customize by clicking on the default settings button. Then, through geometry method, you can change the way to drop the object, and through the structure section, you can change the object's appearance. ArchiCAD is also quite smart. Walls do merge if they're dropped close enough. Differently from 2D objects, you have to be careful on where 3D objects lay. While drawing, the 3D objects in progress always lay on the blue grid on your workspace while using a 3D preview. By default, this is linked to the ground floor, but if you click on its symbol, you can choose a different height by using Snap to Story. Or choose a custom height level by using Offset. All new objects will lay on the new base just set. Then, you have the Door and the Window tools used to drop a template of a door or a window on an existing wall. As seen before, use the info box above to change the template and its settings, such as its size. In particular, use the Still or Header Height section to regulate at which height the door or window must lay. Click on the right black arrow to change the base of the door or window, choosing a wall base or top or even a story by going to Relink Anchor Story. You can also add an offset from the base chosen by typing More below. Once the door or window is dropped, you can decide the way and how to open it by clicking on the pink rhombus. To cover walls, you have to use the Roof tool. Differently from other templates in the main section, you choose just the pattern to show off. In fact, the roof shape is not determined by a template, but by the shape of the walls it lays on. When you enable the Roof tool, adjusting the settings in the info box, under Geometry Method, select Single Plane to drop a plane roof, or Multiplane to drop a more complex one. ArchiCAD is smart and selects the right blue grid depending on the height of the wall. Under Construction Method, choose how to draw the roof. For more complex templates like stairs, chairs, and beds, use the Stair tool and the Object tool. Choose the template by clicking on the Default Settings button and personalize it as you like. As seen for walls and columns, use the blue grid to set the base these objects must lay on. In ArchiCAD, you can also draw 2D objects in a 3D environment by using the Morph tool. In fact, if you use the 2D tools in the Document section, you will draw lines and polygons, but these are not made for a 3D environment composed by elevations, stories, and 3D previews. When enabling the Morph tool, you can draw lines and polygons that are shown in a 3D preview. This works just like the Polyline tool by fixing points and segments. When you create a closed path, the object is automatically filled by using the structure options in the info box. Let's see all the drawing and editing tools inside a 3D environment. As long as you work with 3D objects by using an elevation or a story view, you can edit and manage them just like 2D objects with the same key points, editing tools, and guidelines. But when you switch to a 3D environment, you will have extra tools and features available. Respect to a 2D environment, you have three main axes. X and Y are used to represent length and width, whereas the Z-axis is used for the height. You also have the key points, check marks for vertices, star triangles for points on edges, and a rhombus icon for a point taken on a face. Also, in a 3D environment, you have the editing tools inside the dialog box that appears when you click on Nodes, Paths, or Faces. You can use the Drag, Rotate, Mirror, and Multiply, Offset, Fillet Camper tools, just like 2D objects, but you also have other editing tools. For example, if you have a polygon, you can transform it into a 3D object by adding extrusions on it with the Tube tool. This creates a 3D conductor by taking the polygon as a section and stops when you click on the latest point fixed when your pointer becomes a black pencil. If you click on a point, you can use Box Stretch to stretch the 3D object by editing its 3D contour. If you click on a vertex, you can apply a 3D Fillet Camper tool on it, or use the pencil icon to enable the Morph tool again. If you click on an edge, you can apply a 3D Fillet Camper tool on that single edge only. If you click on a face, you can use Bulge to distort a face by fixing a radius and its intensity. If you click on a wall vertex, you can use Stretch Height to change its height or Modify Angle to add angle respect to the main Z-axis. Of course, you can use the advanced editing tools inside the standard bar also on 3D objects. You can also personalize objects coming from a template. Just right-click on the object and go to Convert Selection to Morph. If you want to start drawing without using any template, enable the Mesh tool and click and drag to create a box. From this simple polygon, you can start designing by modifying it with the editing tool seen. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel for more amazing videos and full guides for free.